So this was both a simple and a radical idea. The notion every human being possesses certain legal rights by virtue of her humanity. Today's protesters are largely turning away from universal human rights language. And its greatest traditional champion, the United States, holds less promise for activists who are coming up with strategies for their movements today than it did 10 years ago. The people seeking asylum in the United States, the people that Hardy and his team are privileged to call their clients, they are doing so for the simple reason that they